Okay, good afternoon everyone, and welcome to Retailing Management online class. Okay, so today we are going to continue with chapter number 2 from unit 1. Okay, so where we are learning types of retailers. Okay, so this is Dr. Mahesh M. Vanjeri, assistant professor from Department of Management Studies, SDM College of Engineering and Technology, Dharwad. So before I continue with the non-food retailers. So in yesterday class we learnt about the types of food retailers. So in today's class we are going to learn about non-food retailers. So before that, let me briefly discuss about this news from yesterday's newspaper. So the news is from Times of India, September 8, 2020, from Times Business Column. Retailers across India to bank on just-in-time strategy due to COVID. So I repeat, retailers in India, okay, will bank on just-in-time strategy due to COVID. So if you look at the first, in the middle of the news, okay, there are two highlights. It says the festive challenge. Okay, so the first highlight says all forecasting and demand planning have gone for a toss, and it will be a gut feel driven festive season this time. Devendra Chawla, MD and CEO at Spencer's Retail, okay, and Nature's Basket. Okay, so I hope you might have heard about these retailers. Then one more highlight, this time liquidity is the biggest challenge, as consumers would want to save due to lower disposable income. Kamal Nandi, business head and executive vice president at Godrej Appliances. Okay, so I'll just read one part of the news and we'll discuss based on the two highlights that are in the middle of the news. Retailers in India, from Benetton and Spencer's Retail to Puma and Godrej Appliances, have adopted a just-in-time strategy for the festive season, a departure from their 3 to 4 month long preparation time during pre-COVID days. These include strategy and inventory planning, finance options and discounts, as the pandemic has put everything in a state of flux. As we get closer to Diwali, we will figure out which plan will work, said Devendra Chawla, MD and CEO at Spencer's Retail and Nature's Basket. All forecasting and demand planning have gone for a toss, and it will be a gut feel driven festive season this time. So what will be the major change in the way companies handle inventory? Godrej Appliances, for instance, expects its trade partners, means wholesalers and retailers, okay, to stock up for about 10 to 15 days based on the demand, while last year it was for a month. Okay, so pay attention, what is the change in the strategy for this Diwali season? So first let me talk about the Diwali season. See, Diwali season is the biggest season in India for consumer durables, many of the consumer products, appliances, apparels, automobiles, okay, and so on. So try to understand, Diwali is the biggest season. Okay, like in West, Christmas is the biggest season. So highest amount of sales are made during the Diwali season for most of the categories of products. So if during the previous normal years, the dealers of consumer electronics or consumer durables, okay, in general held an inventory for 1 month. So how much is required to sell for the entire month of Diwali? So they used to hold the stock or inventory of 1 month. Accordingly, they used to order to the manufacturers. But this time Godrej Appliances says, okay, so their trade partners, means dealers in respective towns and cities, will hold the inventory only for 10 to 15 days. This means, okay, the demand will be less than the normal compared to previous years. So looking at the inventory, okay, So it looks like the demand is going to be very low. So if the retailers hold a higher level of inventory, say for example 1 month, okay, but and if it does not get sold, okay, then there will be huge loss across the supply chain. So the first strategy is with respect to inventory, where instead of 1 month stock, the dealers or retailers will be holding only up to 10 to 15 days of inventory, and that too based on demand. And the second, okay, which is mentioned here in the first part. And second part is about the liquidity. So when we talk about liquidity, liquidity of the consumers who are going to buy during the Diwali season. Okay, so if you can recall during the last 6 months due to the COVID pandemic, many of the people have lost their employment or salary has been reduced. So the income also has been reduced for these people or customers. So it is very unlikely that these consumers will spend big during the Diwali season. So that is the reason why the companies may plan for some finance options, which is mentioned here, and discounts, which will motivate the customer to buy or which will increase help increase demand. So this is how the retailers across India and other companies are gearing up for this just-in-time strategy due to the crisis brought on by the COVID pandemic. So as a student of retailing management, you need to know this, understand this, and remember this. Okay, definitely if a retail chain is going to come for recruitment, okay, questions related to this are quite natural. And you cannot say, I don't know, I have not read newspaper. So with this discussion, if you have any questions, they will be entertained at the end. Let me continue, okay, with chapter number 2, non-food retailers. Okay, Sharon, can you see the PowerPoint slides?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. See, in yesterday's class, I forgot for a new share. I kept on reading the PPT and explaining. Nobody told me that PPT was not visible to you. Yes or no? Sharon?
It was visible, sir.
Visible for you people?
Yes, sir. I saw, sir.
Okay, but because it is not there in the recording anyway, I shared the PPT in advance for this chapter.
Okay, sir.
Okay, anyway. So if it was visible for you, then good, no problem. So in yesterday's class, we learned about the types of retailers, organized retailers, and second important aspect, brick and mortar retailers, B-R-I-C-K, brick, M-O-R-T-A-R, mortar, brick and mortar retailers means store based retailers. So they are broadly classified as food retailers and general merchandise retailers. So yesterday we learned about these food retailers, supermarkets, big box food retailers, who are further classified as super centers, hypermarkets, and warehouse clubs. And then finally, convenience stores. So today we are going to learn about general merchandise retailers. Okay, so I hope all the stages set to learn about the general merchandise retailers. Okay. So the first among the general merchandise retailers means non-food retailers. Food is not sold in these types of stores. So among the general merchandise retailers, the first type of stores are called the discount stores. Discount stores offers a broad variety of merchandise, limited service, and low prices. So please pay attention. These are the characteristics of a discount store. So I repeat, discount stores offer a broad variety of merchandise, limited service, and low prices. Discount stores offer both private labels as well as national brands. So let me explain here what is meant by a private label. Okay, private label is also a brand which is owned and marketed by a retailer. I repeat, private label is also a brand, but which is owned and marketed by the retailer. So if you visit a Big Bazaar, okay, so there is a brand of toilet cleaner next to Harpic. Harpic is the undisputed market leader in India, okay, among the toilet cleaning liquids. So next to Harpic, there is another brand called the CleanMate. Okay, so this CleanMate brand of toilet cleaner is a private label of Big Bazaar. Same way, if you visit more store, so you will see there many grocery products branded in terms of more, like more branded rice, more branded sugar in packaged, okay, condition I'm talking. Then more branded air fresheners, more branded room fresheners, so many products, okay. So who are branded as more, okay. So these kind of private labels you'll find in many stores. So discount stores offer both private labels as well as national brands. And there'll be few stores which will sell only private labels. Okay, for example, Easy Day. If you have visited Easy Day, Max, they sell only private labels. And national brands are, okay, those brands which are owned and marketed by other manufacturers. Say for example, Harpic is manufactured and marketed by Reckitt Benckiser. Red Label Tea is manufactured and marketed by Hindustan Unilever Limited. Levi's Jeans, okay, is manufactured and marketed by Levi-Strauss and Company. So I hope the difference between private labels and national brands is clear. So next time when you make a visit to organized retail stores, you can identify some of the private labels and discuss during the class. Examples of discount stores are Walmart, Kmart, Target. Okay. So as of now, there is no clarity on this format in India. Okay, as Big Bazaar, DMart are categorized as hypermarkets. Okay, but there was one word used. I had this book, Business World, the marketing white book, which is published annually once in a year. So 2005, they mentioned Subhiksha as a discount store. Okay, for anybody want to challenge. Okay, but Subhiksha was more like a supermarket. Okay, maybe way back then, 2005, 15 years ago, 1.5 decade ago, the terms were not very clear for even in India. So maybe the word discount store might have been wrongly used. But anyway, if you want to write the example, now it is obsolete. It doesn't exist. Okay. So clear examples of discount stores are Walmart, Kmart, and Target. Okay, American retail chains. So this is the image of a Walmart discount store. Okay. Then second type of general merchandise retailer is specialty stores. Is specialty stores. Specialty stores concentrate on a limited number of complementary merchandise categories and provides a high level of service in an area typically under 8,000 square feet. Okay, so as I already mentioned, the size of the store in terms of square feet, this all is with respect to American, with reference to stores in America. Okay, but just for understanding purpose, we are using them. In India, the size may vary, because if you see the Wildcraft store in Hubballi, So if you see the Wildcraft store in Hubballi, Urban Oasis Mall, okay, it is not of 8,000 square feet. It's a very small store. Okay, so let me focus here again on what is a specialty store. Specialty stores concentrates on a limited number of complementary means which support one another or which are required together or which are used together. Okay, so concentrates on a limited number of complementary merchandise categories and provides a high level of service in an area typically under 8,000 square feet. So the Indian example for specialty stores are Wildcraft. So those who are aware about the brand, okay, so those who have visited the Wildcraft store in Hubballi Urban Oasis Mall, first floor it is there. Okay, so basically they sell merchandise required for travel and adventure. Now what are the complementary merchandise categories that are required for travel and adventure? So if you have a hobby of travel and adventure, so you can recall what all types of products we carry along with us. First thing, definitely shoes for travel or trekking, apparels like shorts, t-shirts, okay, then backpacks, hats, okay, then maybe camping gear, camp and other accessories. So look at the wrist watches, especially that are required for trekking and travel, water bottles, okay, so compass and so many other aspects. So we call travel and adventure. Wildcraft, okay, is a specialty store selling merchandise related to, or selling complementary merchandise categories related to travel and adventure. So there was a store, okay, on a Brigade Road in Bangalore, which I visited, Planet M. So which was selling the merchandise related to music, audio cassettes, CDs, DVDs, okay, and various other video CDs, video DVDs, okay, and many other products that are related to music and entertainment. But that this store now is a part of the Crossbook, okay, part of the Crossword bookstore. Then later Crossword also became part of another lifestyle store, okay, because the demand for video CDs, audio CDs, okay, went on shrinking, and the demand for books also went on shrinking due to the innovation of e-books and music on internet. But anyway, so you can remember this example, Wildcraft. We'll consider others later. So this is the image of Wildcraft store. This is the actual store from Hubballi, okay, Urban Oasis Mall, first store. So you can make out it's a very small store. It is not 8,000 square feet. And these are the complementary, okay, merchandise categories which they sell required for travel and adventure. And okay, so there will be a small assignment for you. How Wildcraft, okay, Wildcraft is a market leader, okay, among the retail chains that sell merchandise related to travel and adventure, undisputed market leader, okay. So but how the company started, it's a very interesting story. So I am giving you it as an assignment. In my next class, I'm going to ask the story behind beginning of the Wildcraft brand and business. So somebody should, you go to their website, about us you go, or you find the story or history and you'll read it. It's very interesting. And I want somebody to narrate that story in next class. Okay. Yeah. So we'll move on to the next type of general merchandise retailers. Okay. So the next type of general merchandise retailers are category specialists. So you need to remember these terms. Okay. The third type of general merchandise retailers are referred to as category specialist. So category specialist is a discount store that offers a narrow variety but deep assortment of merchandise. I'll explain the meaning of that by giving example. And these are basically discount specialty stores. Okay, so if you consider a store called Decathlon in Hubballi. So I have a store called Decathlon in Hubballi. I would like to consider this example to make you understand what does it mean when I say category specialist offers a narrow variety but a deep assortment of merchandise. So I hope most of you or some of you might have visited Decathlon store in Hubballi. So it's a huge store, as you can see. Okay. and it sells only one category of goods, that is sports equipment. So they are referred as category specialist. Only one category of merchandise related to sports. Then, so what is the meaning of narrow variety but deep assortment? So when you say variety, I hope the general term of variety you understand, wide variety or small variety. So category specialists maintain a narrow variety, a small variety of merchandise but deep assortment. So if you can recall a Big Bazaar example when I gave as a hypermarket and what categories of goods they sell a wide variety of merchandise but few items in each category. It is the reverse of that. Category specialist is the reverse of that. Category specialist maintain very narrow or few variety of categories of goods, but in each variety, each category or each variety, a number of items they maintain, a deep assortment of merchandise. So I'll compare the sports section of Big Bazaar with the Decathlon. So I already mentioned Big Bazaar also sells sports equipments. Say for example, if you want to buy a football, okay, so you can buy football from sports equipment department or at Big Bazaar or in Decathlon. So where you will find more varieties of, okay, where you will find more items of football, different types of football, different sizes, different prices, different materials. So where will you find? Definitely, yes, it is in Decathlon, because Decathlon focuses only on sports goods, whereas Big Bazaar focuses on a variety of category of merchandise, but in each category, they maintain few items. So this is exactly reverse of hypermarket. And there is one term in category specialist called the category killers. So first let us understand what is the meaning of category killers. By offering a complete assortment in a category at low prices. I repeat, by offering a complete assortment in a category at low prices, as I mentioned, say football, if you take everything, almost everything you want to buy related to football, yes, it will be available in Decathlon, and which sells at a low prices. Category specialists can kill a category of merchandise for other retailers. So imagine now, say you are going to buy a football and you are standing in middle of Big Bazaar and Decathlon. Okay, hardly about 100, 200 meter distance is there between both the stores. Okay, so where will you consider to buy? Definitely Decathlon. Why? Because you will have a different types of variety of footballs available in Decathlon as compared to Big Bazaar. Okay, so customers who wanted to buy sports equipments from Big Bazaar sports section, most of them will shift or switch to Decathlon sports store, because Decathlon maintains a deep assortment of the sports merchandise as well as they sell it at a lower price. Okay, then the sale for sports equipment at Big Bazaar may reduce, and it's not only for a sports section of Big Bazaar. I hope you can understand that most of the cities and towns will have sports stores. Like in Dharwad, we have one Kiran Sports. Okay, like that in Hubballi also there are many sports stores, and those customers who used to buy earlier from the local sports stores, okay, they may shift to Decathlon because they find a wide variety of sports equipments at Decathlon. So the business of the local sports stores may be affected. That's why category specialists are also called as category killers. Okay, so other examples for category specialists are Reliance Digital, okay, which sells category of consumer electronics goods. Staples is another example of category specialist, which sells only office consumables and stationery. Okay, you would definitely wonder to look at a large store selling only office stationery. I have seen it in Kormangala, Bengaluru. Okay, so if you get a chance, please do visit. So this is the image of a Staples store. Okay, believe me, they sell only pencil, eraser, sharpener, safety pins, paper pins, okay, paper printing, cartridges for printers, and all office stationery, whatever you want to buy. Printers, okay, copier machines, anything is required for a office. The next type of general merchandise retailer is department stores. Okay, so department stores. So this is the largest format store. Okay, which caters to consumers like me and you, who buy for their personal use or family use. Okay, please pay attention. Department stores are the largest format stores that sell to customers like me and you. Department stores carry a broad variety as well as a deep assortment. See what happened in hypermarket. Hypermarket also carry a broad variety of merchandise, but in each variety or each category, they maintain a narrow assortment, very few items. Okay. So, and whereas a department store not only carry a wide variety of categories of merchandise, but in each variety or in each category, they also maintain many items or deep assortment. That's why I called this format the largest. So department stores carry a broad variety and deep assortment, offer some customer services, and are organized into separate departments for displaying merchandise. So if you have visited, okay, a department store, so the moment you go to different departments or sections inside that store, each section will look like a separate store. Okay, you will feel as if though you have entered into a shopping mall. So it's so huge. Okay, so some examples of the merchandise categories of what is sold by department stores are women's, men's and children's clothing, furniture, kitchenware, appliances. Okay, you name it, they sell it. Okay, so that all is required for a household or a family. So some examples include Sears. Okay, and the Indian example is Shoppers Stop. Okay, Shoppers Stop. Okay, so I have visited two Shoppers Stop stores, one in Mumbai, okay, and one in Bengaluru. So Bengaluru on Bannerghatta Road. Okay, so in 2000, okay, once when I visited Bengaluru along with my friends, I remember we went in front of that store. Okay, believe me, okay, we didn't have any idea about organized retailing nor about Shoppers Stop. And we had a small discussion among ourselves as to what is this building. We got a huge store, and one among the student was an engineer and MBA with us. He was more intelligent among us. So he mentioned, he said it is a retail store. And we all laughed at him. Okay, please try to understand, okay, the reason behind laughing at him. The store was so huge, the building was so big. Okay, it was not possible for us to believe that it was a retail store who buys merchandise from manufacturers and sells it to the end users for a margin. It was so huge. That store is still there. Okay, so later when I started working, I get to shop in the store. Okay, so I visited the floors, sections. Definitely it is amazing. So no need to buy. Even if you want to visit, you can visit. Nobody will, okay, make you feel inconvenient. Okay, they will always smile at you. Only if you want, they will come and assist you. But you can go and make a visit. Okay, so Shoppers Stop is an Indian example for department stores. So here is the image of Shoppers Stop. So what you can see here. Okay, so as I already mentioned, it just looks like a shopping mall from inside. It is so huge. And each section of the store, okay, is a separate store in itself. Okay, and in many cases, each section may will also have a POS, that is the point of sale. Okay, so that was all about department stores. Okay, so I think I will pause here. Okay, and let me go for your queries. Okay, so I have kept an option where you can enable to unmute yourself from your end. You can unmute from your end. So those who have any questions, please ask and mute yourself again.
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Yes, Sharan.
Sir, can this Big Bazaar can be included in this departmental stores category, sir?
Yeah, 1 minute.
Yes, sir.
See, Sharan, are you listening?
Yes, sir.
As I said, okay, see, this concept of modern retail or organized retail is first of all not Indian.
Yes, sir.
Okay, it has come from the West, like many of the English movies that are copied in Hindi, right?
Yes,
okay
sir.
then we are referring the American book. Okay, so when we say a burger in America, okay, or McDonald's restaurant, and when you call it a burger in our bakery in college, okay, so both are called as burgers, but the burger you eat in bakery is not a burger, but still
yes,
we eat it. Okay, so that way many terms, jargons are coined, switched, changed, and used according to convenience in India.
Okay, sir.
So yes, I do remember initially when Big Bazaar started its stores. Okay, in some media, see, like Business Today has referred to Subhiksha, which was a supermarket, as a department, as a department store or a hypermarket. Okay, wrongly it was mentioned. Discount store. They mentioned it. So same way, initially I do remember some people and some media referred to Big Bazaar as a department store. But later they have stopped it. Now in very clear in books as well as in media, Big Bazaar is referred to as a hypermarket.
Okay, sir.
Okay, it is only due to lack of knowledge and liberty give people take in changing and switching the contents, terminologies, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, like your Bahubali movie. Huh? Even if I show you the original movie, you won't believe that it is a copy. There is a movie called Gladiator.
Yes, sir. Old
okay.
one.
So the full story is a direct copy of a movie called Gladiator. But if you watch it, you won't make it because they have Indianized it. Okay. Yes. Next question. Yeah, students. I discussed the news also in the beginning. Any news, any information related to that, or any questions you have related to so far whatever types of general merchandise retailers I discussed? Yeah, see, again there is pin drop silence. And the attendance is low today. So one class was scheduled earlier, which I saw in the group, 12 to 1. That does not mean students can remain absent. As I said, this will not be repeated when you join back the college in October. And whatever is taught online, this will be considered for IA1 as well as for semester end examination. And I already told your attendance also continues. CRs, both the CRs, kindly convey this in your private group. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Any questions? Did you read anything related to retail news? Yes. No. Are you sure? Okay. So let us see who is there. Rahul, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
What are you planning to buy this Diwali season?
I'm planning to buy the bike accessories, sir.
Accessories, why not a new bike?
New bike is already brought, sir, like last May.
Already purchased?
Yeah, already purchased.
When?
May, second week.
May you purchased, okay. So he has already made a purchase during COVID.
Yeah, sir. Full, like BS6 model.
Okay, very good. Very good. Okay.
So I need to purchase now accessories for it.
Okay, good. Please do buy. And please do buy, help Indian economy revive. Okay.
but yeah, sir, like show that this one, sir, that newspaper article, I had doubts, sir.
You are not decided totally.
No, sir. Like, yeah, but that is the adverse effect of a, like of inflation, no, sir. What you told, like 15 days, 30 days.
Yes, yes, that is true.
Because of the inflation, that thing will occur.
Yeah, yeah. Rahul, I will stop this meeting, and you please join the next.